You know, it's funny, you know, in the course that I went through at Georgia Tech, you know, by the time we were through one part of the course, you know, you were probably, you know, early on, just if you just learned HTML, you could just focus on one piece of the full stack, by the way, as an entry point. You may not want to try and digest it all. It's a lot. And not every company needs you to handle everything. So the, you know, an entry point might be you just know HTML and CSS very, really well. And you can actually now go out and or PHP and build websites for people. So your entry point could be at that level doing the front end. The entry point could be as simple as, you know, just doing some you know, some middleware, if you will, in the stack, some JavaScript or other. Or you could just really love databases and want to focus on database. So you could be either on the front end or the back end. There's lots of opportunities for the entry point. Typical is probably what you love. I think you got to really focus on the area where you excel and you love and you have a mastery of it. That makes you the ultimate candidate to at least get in and start to explore the environment. You know, you're going to hear terms around, you're regularly going to hear senior full stack developer. What does that mean? I think that means different things to different companies, first of all, but there's a likely scenario of something you might hear. You could hear junior. It sounds like it's just somebody without as much experience, or maybe they just don't have, in some cases, a junior could be acting like a senior at another company. So the typical titles, full stack developer, include junior, senior, entry level, you might hear that. Or it could just be something totally a little bit different, and they don't even use the word full stack. It could be UI, UX, or just front end developer. So those are some examples of what you might Google or put in your job search on LinkedIn and try and find jobs around that space. So not many companies misuse the term full stack as their need. The reality is most of it is compartmentalized to front end or back end, and or they've got some hybrid of it. So, you know, use your Google Foo skills, be a good Googler, search for terms, open up your terms, and then find titles, if you will, to start with. And I think you'll find that that can give you the most flexibility. Companies do follow each other and they tend to use the word full stack, and then they add a word on the front end or the back end of that.